Hey guys, I'm Theo Joe, and today I'm going to show you how you can triple your Wi-Fi speed at no cost. This is going to be using things you already have in your house, and I think you're going to be surprised about how easy it really is. To do this, you're only going to need three different things. First of all, you're going to need an external wireless adapter. It has to be external because we have to have the antenna to work with. If there's no antenna that we can see, then it's going to be hard to do this. Next, you're going to need a pair of AAA batteries, preferably rechargeable. You could use non-rechargeables, but they'll lose effectiveness over time, so if you can, you want to use rechargeables. Finally, you're just going to need some electrical tape. It's important to use electrical tape because it conducts electricity. It's going to work better. All right, so let me show you what you have to do. Take the adapter and take a little bit of electrical tape and then attach the batteries with the tape so they're maybe halfway up or a little bit lower up the shaft of the adapter antenna, and you want the batteries to be facing the same direction towards the top at about the same height, and then also across from each other. So you don't want them to be touching at all. You should have it ending up looking like this, where they're both positive end facing up or positive end facing down. Doesn't really matter as long as they're facing the same direction. And this is about all you need to do. You don't have to cover it in electrical tape or anything. And I wouldn't recommend putting it too high on the antenna because you don't want to weigh down the adapter or anything like that. You don't want to use more than two batteries because it really doesn't help and it's just going to weigh down your antenna. These two batteries are going to essentially triple the speed of your wireless adapter through magnetic induction. It basically attracts the signal, amplifies it using the induction, and then transmits it into your computer. And of course, I want to know exactly how much this is going to increase the speed, so why don't we go to the computer and I'll do a speed test, the wireless antenna without the batteries, and then with it afterwards and see what it does. All right, so here we are at the computer on speedtest.net. I'm just going to record right off the screen so you can see the before and after. This is without the batteries on the antenna. It's right here. And let's see what the baseline test is with no antenna modification, and then we'll compare it afterwards. So see the download speed. It's gonna be a all right, it's a bit slower today even. All right, so it's gonna be probably between four and five, maybe even 5.5. Okay, maybe even around 6. And then we'll see what the upload does. Looks like the upload speed is probably going to be around the same, if not a little bit higher. It's the middle of the day, lots of congestion, I guess. Okay. So around the same, but a little bit lower. So now I'm going to compare and add the batteries onto this and then come back and we'll do a second test. Okay, so I put the batteries on the antenna, so now it should be significantly faster. And let's do another test and see what the results are. Wow, look at the difference. Oh my gosh. Wow. I suspect the first test was slower than it should have been, but I mean, look at that difference. It obviously more than tripled it. I wouldn't expect that kind of difference. I think the first test might have just been slow, but there's definitely a difference right there. We went from, it was a tenfold increase. Usually I get around 20 megabits a second on the download. So it's still three times what I normally get. And I guess during busy times, you might even get a huge increase like this. So obviously there was a major difference with the batteries on it. All right, so as you can see in that test, it had a huge effect on the speed. I'm actually surprised that was a great result. Now, this isn't going to increase the range because it can only amplify whatever signal is already reaching the antenna. So if you have a weak signal, it's still going to be weak. So hopefully this helped you guys. I'm really looking forward to finding out how this worked for you. If you want, you can leave a comment in the section below and let us all know how it went. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it and others will as well. If you want to continue watching, I've got some other videos and tutorials on the right hand side. You can either click those or look in the description for the same link, like if you're on a phone. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos 3 times a week, so I think it should be worth it. So I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys either in the comment section or on Twitter or somewhere else. So thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Have a good one.